Surfing, you've been my greatest teacher. You had me at the start, in the middle, and now at the end. You have always been my great escape to stillness. But who am I without my board? What do I want to leave behind? What part of my story will my daughter remember?
Trying hard when the night is long. I wish I could believe. Wish I could believe.
Children are born environmentalists. They love nature and all her creatures. If there's one great tool to give our children, it's the love of nature. As parents, how do we keep that connection alive?
Living wisdom. I wish I could believe we've come so far.
I think we've reached a time in history where we need to start really thinking about our future.
We don't put the connection or immersion into the environment as a priority within our school systems. Kids aren't brought out into the environment to be taught about the seasons, the changes that happen from a connection point of view. They might learn about it in books, but they don't really attach to it. We need to put greater emphasis back into connecting people to the places that they live in.
The way that I see country is from a topographical point of view. I always have visions of being above country, floating above it. That's sort of how I paint it. For us growing up, a lot of the knowledge, cultural knowledge, is passed down through storytelling, which was cool because going to school and learning the way we did was pretty miserable for a lot of us. You know, that's a huge learning curve growing up. You listen to your elders, you hear stories, you listen to the stories, and then you sort of get taught to understand them, why they are there, and your place in those stories. Indigenous people have been talking about how the climate's changing for the last 30 years and no one's listened to any of us. You know, it takes things like this to wake people up and acknowledge that our connection is far greater than what a lot of people think it is.
Spending time in the ocean makes you want to protect it. I think every father dreams of that day, watching his daughter dance down the line of a wave in all her beauty. My responsibility as Willow's father is to keep her spirit strong, to nourish her connection with the earth. Families that play together stay together. And it takes a brave man to play like a child.
Our connection to country is so powerful. You know, you forget that the trees are our lungs and the animals are our ancestors. And to see it all perish the way it has, and sad times.
On the 8th of November, a monster of a fire tore through this valley, the Nambucca Valley. It tore this place apart. We stayed and defended our house. We had two fire crews, bloody professionals, really good job. I'm really appreciative of their help. Without them, we would not be living in our house where we've been for 30 odd years. Thank you.
One of the common views I think we have on nature at the moment is that we need to leave it alone to give it a chance to regenerate. And certainly there's a lot of merit to that idea, but we have an opportunity to take that one step further, and we can do positive things that help the environment.
Our oceans and reefs are a laboratory of continents, the origin of all things living. Every year for the past decade, I've journeyed out to sea in pursuit of restoring coral and reconnecting with nature. For me, this is my radio silence, an opportunity to digest unnecessary hype with our modern day society.
I've grown up next to the ocean my whole life, and I think for a lot of us on this trip, the ocean has been our second mother. I'm so proud to have the reef as part of my heritage, and one of the things that my dad always reflects on is how different the reef was when he was a kid. And if Willow takes 50 years to come back here to visit, then it could be a lot different in 50 years' time.
I wanted the next generation to be able to experience this ecosystem for what it is. We are here for only a glimpse of time, yet our impact is forever. And with that, I believe if these children will harness what it means to protect it for decades to come.
Never before have we experienced fires like the present. They challenge us to reassess our whole approach to living on this continent. We must reconnect with the wild places, stand side by side with our traditional owners, and awaken the environmentalists we were as children, to weave a new narrative for this country, one that our children can align with as they grow. I stand for a world that cares for nature, a world that my daughter deserves, and so does yours.